अनुसूचित जातियों तथा अनुसूचित जनजाति के कल्याण संबंधी समिति तथा ग्रामीण विकास संबंधी समिति के सदस्य थे। श्री चिंतामन मनगा का निधन 30 जनवरी 2018 को 67 वर्ष की आयु में नई दिल्ली में हुआ। हम अपने साथी के निधन पर गहरा शोक व्यक्त करते हैं। मुझे विश्वास है शोक संतप्त परिवार के प्रति अपनी संवेदना व्यक्त करने में यह सभा मेरे साथ है। अब यह सभा दिवंगत आत्मा के सम्मान में कुछ देर मौन रहेगी। ओम शांति। माननीय सदस्यगण, वर्तमान सदस्य का निधन हो जाने की स्थिति में स्थापित परंपरा के अनुसार सदस्य के निधन संबंधी उल्लेख के पश्चात सभा सम्मान स्वरूप पूरे दिन के लिए स्थगित हो जाती है। स्थापित परंपरा के मद्देनजर सभा को पूरे दिन के लिए स्थगित किया जाना चाहिए था, परंतु जैसा कि आप सभी भलीभांति जानते हैं, आज की बैठक माननीय राष्ट्रपति जी द्वारा विशेष रूप से वित्त वर्ष 2018-19 के केंद्रीय बजट को प्रस्तुत करने के लिए निर्धारित की गई है, जो एक संवैधानिक जिम्मेदारी है। अतः इस असाधारण स्थिति के कारण सभा में वित्त वर्ष 2018-19 के लिए केंद्रीय बजट प्रस्तुत करने के संवैधानिक कार्य को पूर्ण किया जाएगा। दिवंगत आत्मा के सम्मान में सभा की बैठक कल अर्थात 2 फरवरी 2018 को नहीं होगी। धन्यवाद। नाउ बजट, माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी।
मैडम स्पीकर, I rise to present the budget for the year 2018-19. Madam, 4 years ago, we pledged to the people of India to give to this nation an honest, clean and transparent government. We promised a leadership capable of taking difficult decisions and restoring strong performance of Indian economy. We promised to reduce poverty, expedite infrastructure creation, and build a strong, confident and new India. When our government took over, India was considered a part of the fragile five, a nation suffering from policy paralysis and corruption. We have decisively reversed this. The government led by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi has successfully implemented a series of fundamental structural reforms. With the result, India stands out as amongst the fastest growing economies in the world. The journey of economic reforms during the past few years has been challenging but rewarding. As a result of the reforms undertaken by the government, foreign direct investment has gone up. Measures taken by the government have made it easier to do business in India. Natural resources are now allocated in a transparent and honest manner. There is a premium on honesty. Ek samay tha jab bhrashtachar shishtachar ka ang ban gaya tha. Aaj hamare nagrik vishesh roop se navyuvak varg imandari ka jeevan vyatit karne ko tatpar hai. The indirect tax system with the introduction of the goods and services tax has been made simpler. Benefits to the poor has been targeted more effectively with the use of digital technology. The demonetization of high value currency has reduced the quantum of cash currency in circulation. It has increased the taxation base and spurred greater digitization of the Indian economy. The insolvency and the bankruptcy code has changed the lender-debtor relationship. The recapitalized banks have now a greater ability to support growth. All these structural reforms will help the Indian economy achieve stronger growth in the medium and long term. Indian economy has performed very well since our government took over in May 2014. India achieved an average growth of 7.5% in the first 3 years of our government. Indian economy is now a $2.5 trillion economy, seventh largest in the world. India is expected to become the fifth largest economy very soon. On purchasing power parity basis, we are already the third largest economy. Indian society, polity and economy have shown remarkable resilience in adjusting with structural reforms. The GDP growth at 6.3% in the second quarter signaled a turnaround of the economy. We hope to grow at 7.2 to 7.5% in the second half. The IMF in its latest update has forecast that India will grow at 7.4% next year. Manufacturing sector is back on the growth path. The services, which is the mainstay of our growth, have also resumed their high growth rate at 8% plus. Our exports are expected to grow at about 15% in 2017-18. We are now firmly on course to achieve a high growth of 8% plus. We have taken up programs to direct the benefits of structural reforms and good growth to reach the farmers, poor and other vulnerable sections of our society to uplift the underdeveloped regions. This year's budget will consolidate these gains and particularly focus on strengthening agriculture and rural economy, provision for good health to economically less privileged, taking care of senior citizens, infrastructure creation, and working with the states to provide more resources for improving the quality of education in the country. The Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, has always stressed the importance of good governance. He has articulated the vision of minimum government and maximum governance. This vision has inspired government agencies in carrying out hundreds of reforms in policies, rules and procedures. This transformation is reflected in the improvement of India's ranking by 42 places in the last 3 years in the World Bank's ease of doing business, with India breaking into the top 100 for the first time. I would like to congratulate all those who worked to achieve this. Hamari Sarkar ab ease of doing business se aage badhkar desh ke jan samanya, visheshkar gareeb aur madhyam varg ki zindagi ko aasan banane ke liye unki ease of living pe zor de rahi hai. Good governance ka aadhar bhi yahi hai ki desh ke aam nagarik ke jeevan mein sarkari dakhal kam se kam ho. Ujwala yojana ke madhyam se sarkar desh ke karodo gareebon ko muft gas connection de rahi hai. सौभाग्य योजना के जरिए 4 करोड़ घरों में बिजली कनेक्शन से जोड़ा जा रहा है. 3000 से ज्यादा जन औषधि केंद्र में 800 से ज्यादा दवाइयां कम कीमत पर बेची जा रही हैं. स्टेंट की कीमत नियंत्रित की जा रही गई है. गरीबों को मुफ्त डायलिसिस सुविधा के लिए विशेष योजना शुरू की गई है. गरीबों और मध्यम वर्ग को आवास योजना की ब्याज दरों से बड़ी राहत भी दी गई है. सरकारी सेवाएं, चाहे बस ट्रेन का टिकट हो या कई तरह के प्रमाण पत्र, सभी ऑनलाइन उपलब्ध करने का प्रयास किया जा रहा है. 2 से 3 दिन के भीतर घर पे आ जाने वाला पासपोर्ट हो या 1 दिन में रजिस्टर होने वाली कंपनी, इससे देश के बड़े वर्ग को लाभ पहुंचा है. सर्टिफिकेट अटेस्टेड कराना की बाध्यता खत्म करना और ग्रुप सी व डी की नौकरियों में इंटरव्यू खत्म करना के लिए न जाने लाखों नौजवानों के समय और पैसे की बचत हुई है. ये सरकार अनावश्यक नियम कायदों के साथ संघर्ष कर रहे हर व्यक्ति को आधुनिक तकनीकी का उपयोग करते हुए राहत देने के लिए प्रतिबद्ध है. Madam, while undertaking these reforms and programs, we have worked sincerely and without weighing the political cost. Our government has ensured that the benefits reach the eligible beneficiaries and are delivered to them directly. Many services and benefits are being delivered to the people at their doorsteps or in their accounts. It has reduced corruption and the cost of delivery and has eliminated the middlemen in the process. The direct benefit transfer mechanism of India is the biggest such exercise in the world and is a global success story. Agriculture and rural economy. My government is committed to the welfare of the farmers. For decades, the country's agricultural policy and programs has remained production-centric. We had sought to effect a paradigm shift. The Honorable Prime Minister gave a clarion call to double the farmers' income by 2022 when India celebrates its 75th year of independence. Our emphasis is on generating higher incomes for farmers. We consider agriculture as an enterprise and want to help the farmers to produce more from the same land parcel at lesser cost and simultaneously realize higher prices for their produce. Our emphasis is also on generating productive and gainful on-farm and non-farm employment for farmers and the landless families. Adhyaksh Mahoday, देश के किसानों के अथक परिश्रम का परिणाम है कि आज देश की कृषि उत्पादन रिकॉर्ड स्तर पर है। वर्ष 2016-17 में लगभग 275 मिलियन टन खाद्यान्न और लगभग 300 मिलियन टन फलों एवं सब्जियों का ऐतिहासिक उत्पादन हुआ है। अध्यक्ष महोदय, हमारे दल के घोषणा पत्र में ये संकल्प है कि कृषि को लाभदारी बनाने के लिए किसान भाइयों को उनकी लागत उत्पादन की लागत से कम 50% से 50% से अधिक अतार्थ लागत से डेढ़ गुना दाम मिले। सरकार इस संकल्प के प्रति संवेदनशील रही है। रबी की अधिकांश अधिघोषित फसलों का न्यूनतम समर्थन मूल्य लागत से कम डेढ़ गुना तय किया जा चुका है। अब हम बची हुई अधिघोषित फसलों के लिए भी इस संकल्प को एक सिद्धांत की तरह लागू करने का फैसला लिया है। मुझे ये घोषणा करते हुए अत्यंत प्रसन्नता का अनुभव हो रहा है कि तय किए गए सिद्धांत के अनुसार सरकार ने आगामी खरीफ की सभी अधिघोषित फसलों का न्यूनतम समर्थन मूल्य उत्पादन लागत से कम डेढ़ गुना करने का फैसला ले लिया है। मेरा विश्वास है कि यह ऐतिहासिक निर्णय किसान भाइयों की आय दुगनी करने की दिशा में एक महत्वपूर्ण कदम साबित होगा। हमारी सरकार किसी भी विषय को टुकड़े टुकड़ों में नहीं वरना समग्रता के साथ सुलझाने की अप्रोच के साथ काम करती है। न्यूनतम समर्थन मूल्य बढ़ा देना ही पर्याप्त नहीं है, ये अधिक महत्वपूर्ण है कि घोषित एमएसपी का पूरा लाभ किसानों को मिले। इसके लिए यह आवश्यक है कि यदि बाजार के दाम एमएसपी से कम हो तो सरकार एमएसपी की खरीदी करे या किसी अन्य व्यवस्था के अंतर्गत ये सुनिश्चित करे कि किसानों को पूरा एमएसपी मिले। नीति आयोग केंद्र एवं राज्य सरकारों के साथ चर्चा कर एक पुख्ता व्यवस्था तैयार करेगा जिससे किसानों को उनकी फसल के उचित दाम दिलवाए जा सकेंगे। फॉर बेटर प्लेसमेंट फॉर बेटर प्राइस रियलाइजेशन फार्मर्स नीड टू मेक डिसीजंस बेस्ड ऑन प्राइजेस लाइकली टू बी अवेलेबल आफ्टर इट्स हार्वेस्ट। Government will create an institutional mechanism with participation of all concerned ministries to develop appropriate policies, practices for price and demand forecast use of future and options market, expansion of warehouse depository system, and to take decisions about specific export and import related measures. Madam Speaker, last year I had announced the strengthening of the ENAM and to expand the coverage of the ENAM to 585 APMCs. 470 APMCs have been connected to ENAM network and the rest will be connected by March 2018. More than 86% of our farmers are small and marginal. They are not in a position to directly transact at APMCs and other wholesale markets. We will develop and upgrade existing 22,000 rural huts into Grameen agricultural markets. In these GRAMs, physical infrastructure will be strengthened by using MNREGA and other government schemes. These GRAMs, electronically linked to ENAMs, are exempted from regulations of the EPMCs and will provide farmers directly to make direct sale to consumers and bulk purchasers. An agri-market infrastructure fund with a corpus of rupees 2,000 crore will be set up for developing and upgrading the agricultural market infrastructure in the 22,000 Grameen agricultural markets and 585 APMCs. The task of connecting all eligible habitations with all-weather roads has been substantially completed, and with the target date brought forward to March 2019 from March 2022. It is now time to strengthen and widen its ambit further to include major link routes with connected and which connect habitations to agricultural and rural markets, higher secondary schools and hospitals. The Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana Phase 3 will include such linkages. हम वर्षों से ये कहते रहे हैं कि भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश है. जैसे भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश है, वैसे ही देश के जिले में किसी न किसी विशिष्ट कृषि उत्पादन की जाने जा सकते हैं, लेकिन हमने इस पर विशेष ध्यान अब तक नहीं दिया. जैसे उद्योग जगत में क्लस्टर बेस्ड विकास का मॉडल अपनाया गया है, वैसे ही हमारे जिलों में विशेष कृषि उत्पादन पदों चिन्हित पर उन्हें वैज्ञानिक तरीके से क्लस्टर मॉडल पर विकसित करने की आवश्यकता है. कल्टीवेशन ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर क्रॉप्स इन क्लस्टर्स brings advantages of scales of operations and can spur establishment of the entire chain of productions to marketing, besides giving recognition to the districts for specific crops. The Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare will reorient the ongoing schemes and promote the cluster-based development of agri-commodities in regions in partnership with ministries of food processing, commerce and other allied ministries. Our government has promoted organic farming in a big way. Organic farming with farmer producer organizations and village producer organizations in large clusters of preferably 1,000 hectares each will be encouraged. Women self-help groups will also be encouraged to take up organic agriculture in clusters under the National Rural Livelihood Program. Our ecology supports cultivation of highly specialized medicinal and aromatic plants. India is also a home to a large number of small and cottage industries which manufacture perfumes, essential oils and other associated products. Our government shall support an organized cultivation of associate industries. I propose to allocate a sum of rupees 200 crores for this purpose. Food processing sector is growing at an average of 8% per annum. The Prime Minister's Krishi Sampada Yojana is our flagship program for boosting the investment in food processing. Allocation in the food processing ministry is being doubled from 715 crore in the RE for 17-18 to 1400 crore in 18-19. The government will promote the establishment of specialized agro-processing and financial institutions in this sector. Tomato, onion and potato are basic vegetables consumed throughout the year. However, seasonal and regional production of these perishable commodities poses a serious challenge in connecting farmers and consumers in a manner that satisfies both. My government proposes to launch an Operation Green on the lines of Operation Flood. Operation Green shall promote farmer producers' organizations, agri-logistics, processing facilities, and professional managements. I propose to allocate a sum of rupees 500 crores for this purpose. India's agri-export potential. India's agri-exports potential is as high as $100 billion against a current support export of rupees of $30 billion. To realize this potential, export of agri commodities will be liberalized. I also propose to set up a state-of-the-art facility in 42 mega food parks. I propose to I propose to extend the facility of Kisan credit cards to fisheries and animal husbandry farmers to help them to meet their working capital needs. Is vyavastha se chote aur simant kisano ko labh milega. Bamboo is green gold. We have removed bamboo grown outside the forest areas from the definition of trees. Now I propose to launch a restructured national bamboo mission with an outlay of rupees 1290 crores to promote bamboo sector in a holistic manner. Many farmers are installing solar water pumps to irrigate their fields. Generation of solar electricity is harvesting by sun by the farmers using their lands. Government will of India will take necessary measures to encourage the state governments to put in place a mechanism that their surplus solar power is purchased by distribution companies or licensees at reasonably remunerative prices. Our government set up a long-term irrigation fund in NABARD for meeting the funding requirements of irrigation work. Scope of the fund would be expanded to cover specified command area in development areas. Last year, I had announced the setting up of the micro irrigation fund for facilitating expansion of coverage under the micro irrigation and dairy processing infrastructure development fund to help finance investment in dairy farming. It is now time to expand such focused investments. I now announce the setting up of a fishery and aquaculture infrastructure development fund of fisheries sector and an animal husbandry infrastructure fund for financing infrastructure requirement in the animal husbandry sector. The total corpus of these two funds would be rupees 10,000 crores. Our government has already steadily increasingly the volume of institutional credit for agricultural sector on a year to year from 8.5 lakh crores in 2014-15 to 10 lakh crores in 2017-18. I now propose to raise this amount to rupees 11 lakh crores for the year 2018-19. Presently, lessee cultivators are not able to avail crop loans. Consequently, a significant portion of the arable land remains hollow, and tenant cultivators are forced to secure credit from usurious money lenders. Niti Aayog, in consultation with the state governments, will evolve a suitable mechanism to enable the access of lessee cultivators to credit without compromising the rights of the landowners. Government will extend a favorable taxation treatment to farmer producer organizations for helping farmers to aggregate the needs of input farm services, processing and sales operation. I shall give the details of this in part B of my speech. Air pollution in the Delhi NCR region has been a cause of concern. A special scheme will be implemented to support the efforts of the government of Haryana, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and NCT Delhi to address the air pollution and subsidized machinery required for an in-situ management of the crop residue. अध्यक्ष महोदय, देश की वर्तमान शीर्ष नेतृत्व गरीबी को बहुत करीब से देखकर गरीबी के में जीकर यहां तक पहुंचा है। एससी एसटी वर्गों की, पिछड़ों की, आर्थिक रूप से कमजोर वर्गों की चिंताएं होती हैं, उन्हें भलीभांति परिचित है। गरीब और मध्यम वर्ग के लिए केस स्टडी नहीं बल्कि वो खुद ही केस स्टडी है। पिछले 3 वर्षों से सरकार की योजनाएं का केंद्र गरीब रहा है, मध्यम वर्ग रहा है। ये सरकार गरीब की छोटी छोटी चिंताओं और बड़ी बड़ी समस्याओं को दूर करने के लिए लगातार कोशिश करती रही है। गरीब महिलाओं की लकड़ी के धुएं से मुक्ति के लिए मिले, इसके लिए प्रधानमंत्री जी ने उज्ज्वला योजना शुरू की थी। शुरुआत में 5 करोड़ गरीब महिलाओं को मुफ्त गैस कनेक्शन का लक्ष्य रखा था, लेकिन इस योजना की गति को देखकर महिलाओं इसकी लोकप्रियता को देखते हुए इसका लक्ष्य बढ़ाने जा रहे हैं। अब सरकार उज्ज्वला योजना के तहत 8 करोड़ गरीब महिलाओं को मुफ्त गैस कनेक्शन देगी। देश में हर गरीब के घर में रोशनी पहुंचे, इसके लिए सरकार द्वारा प्रधानमंत्री सौभाग्य योजना की शुरुआत की गई है। इस योजना के तहत देश के 4 करोड़ गरीब घरों को बिना की कोई शुल्क के बिजली कनेक्शन से जोड़ा जा रहा है। इस योजना पर 16,000 करोड़ रुपए खर्च किए जा रहे हैं। घर का 1 घंटा बिजली ना हो तो हम लोग इधर उधर दौड़ने लगते हैं, टीवी कैसे चलेगा, मोबाइल कैसे चार्ज होगा, लैपटॉप का क्या होगा, ये सोचने लगते हैं। अब आप उन लोगों की सोचिए, उन महिलाओं, उन बच्चों के बारे में सोचिए जिनके घरों में अब बिजली पहुंचेगी तो किस तरह से जिंदगी प्रधानमंत्री सौभाग्य योजना बदलने जा रही है। गरीब को सरकार के स्वच्छ भारत मिशन से बड़ा लाभ पहुंचा है। इस मिशन के तहत सरकार ने अब तक 6 करोड़ से ज्यादा शौचालयों का निर्माण कर चुकी है। इन शौचालयों का सकारात्मक प्रभाव नारी की गरिमा, बेटी की शिक्षा और पूरे परिवार के स्वास्थ्य सुरक्षा पर स्पष्ट रूप से पड़ा है। अगले वित्तीय वर्ष में हमारा लगभग 2 करोड़ शौचालय बनाने का लक्ष्य है। अध्यक्ष महोदया, गरीब की एक चिंता रही है सिर के ऊपर अदद छत की। भ्रष्टाचार करके जुटाई गई बेईमानी संपत्ति से दूर गरीब को बस ईमानदारी की कमाई से एक छत, एक छोटा सा मकान चाहता है। गरीब अपने घर का सपना पूरा कर सके, इसके लिए हमारी सरकार उसकी पूरी मदद कर रही है। हमने लक्ष्य रखा है कि 2022 तक देश के हर गरीब के पास उसका अपना घर हो। इससे लिए ग्रामीण और शहरी इलाकों में प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना शुरू की गई है। प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना ग्रामीण के तहत 2017-18 में 51 लाख और वर्ष 2018-19 में 51 लाख यानी 1 करोड़ से ज़्यादा सिर्फ ग्रामीण इलाकों में बनाए जा रहे हैं। शहरी क्षेत्रों में 37 लाख मकान बनाने के लिए मदद स्वीकृत की गई है। माय गवर्नमेंट विल आल्सो एस्टैब्लिश अ डेडिकेटेड अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग फंड इन द नेशनल हाउसिंग बैंक फंडेड फ्रॉम प्रायोरिटी सेक्टर लेंडिंग शॉर्टफॉल इन फुली सर्विस्ड बॉन्ड्स ऑथराइज्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। लोन्स टू सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स ऑफ वुमेन increased to about 42,000 crores in 16-17, growing 37% over the previous year. The government is confident that the loans to the self-help groups will increase to 75,000 crores by March 2019. I propose to substantially increase the allocation to the National Livelihood Mission to ₹5,750 crores in 2018-19. Groundwater irrigation scheme under the Prime Minister's Krishi Sichai Yojana, Har Khet Ko Pani, will be taken up in the 96 deprived irrigation districts, which where less than 30% of the land holding gets assured irrigation presently. I have allocated ₹2,600 crores for this. As my proposals outlined above indicate, the focus of the government next year will be to provide a maximum livelihood opportunities in the rural areas by spending more on livelihood, agricultural and allied activities, and construction of rural infrastructure. In the year 2018-19, for creation of livelihood and infrastructure in rural areas, a total amount to be spent by ministries will be ₹14.34 lakh crores from extra budgetary and non-budgetary resources of ₹11.98 lakh crores. Apart from employment due to farming activities and self-employment, this expenditure will create 321 crore person days, 3.17 lakh kilometers of rural roads, 51 lakh new rural houses, 1.88 crore toilets, and provide 1.75 crore new household electricity connections, besides boosting agriculture. Details are given in Annexure 1 of this speech. Health, education, and social protection. My government's goal is to assist and provide opportunity to every Indian to realize her full potential, capable of achieving her economic social dreams. Our government is implementing a comprehensive social security and protection program to reach every household of old widows, orphan children, divyang, and deprived, as the socio-economic caste census allocation of National Social Assistance Program has been kept at ₹9,975. We have managed to get children to school, but the quality of education is still a cause of concern. We have now defined learning outcomes of a national survey of more than 20 lakh children has been conducted to assess the status on the ground. This will help in devising a district-wide strategy for improving the quality of education. We now propose to treat education holistically without segmentation from pre-nursery to class 12. Improvement in the quality of teachers can improve the quality of education in the country. We will initiate an integrated B.Ed. program for teachers, training of teachers during the service is extremely critical. We have amended the Right to Education Act to enable more than 13 lakh untrained teachers to get trained. Technology will be the biggest driver in improving the quality of education. We propose to increase the digital intensity in education and move gradually from blackboard to digital board. Technology will also be used to upgrade the skills of teachers through the recently launched digital portal Diksha. The government is committed to provide the best quality education to the tribal children in their own environment. To realize this, it has been decided that by the year 2022, every block with more than 50% scheduled tribe population and at least 20,000 tribal people will have an Ekalya model residential school. Eklavya school will be on par with the Navodaya Vidyalayas and will have special facilities for preserving local art and culture, besides providing training in sports and skill development. To set up investment in research and related infrastructure of premier institutions, including health institutions, I propose to launch a major initiative called the Revitalizing of Infrastructure and Systems in Education, RISE by 2022, with a total investment of ₹1 lakh crore in the next 4 years. Higher Education Financing Agency would be suitably structured for funding this initiative. Our government had taken up the major initiative for setting up an institute of eminence. There has been a tremendous response to this initiative by institutions in both public and private sector. We have received more than 100 applications. We have taken steps to set up a specialized railway university at Vadodara. We propose to set up two new full-fledged schools of planning and architectures to be selected on a challenge mode. Additionally, 18 new schools of planning and architecture would be established in the IITs and the NITs as autonomous schools, also on a challenge basis. The government would also launch the Prime Minister's Research Fellows scheme this year. Under this scheme, we would identify 1,000 best BTEC students each year from premier institutions and provide them with facilities to do PhDs in the IITs and the Indian Institute of Science with a handsome fellowship. It is expected that these bright young fellows would voluntarily commit few hours every week for teaching in a higher educational institution. Now I come to the health sector. Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya is the guiding principle of my government. Only Swasth Bharat can be Smriddh Bharat. India cannot realize its demographic dividend without its citizens being healthy. I am pleased to announce two major initiatives as a part of the Ayushman Bharat program aimed at path-breaking interventions to address the health holistically in primary, secondary and tertiary care systems covering both prevention and health promotion. The National Health Policy 2017 has envisioned that health and wellness centers as the foundation of India's health system. These 1.5 lakh centers will bring healthcare system closer to the homes of the people. These centers will provide a comprehensive healthcare, including a non-communicable diseases and maternal and child services. These centers will also provide free essential drugs and diagnostic services. I am committing rupees 1200 crores in this budget for this flagship program. I am also invite contribution from the private sector through the CSR and the philanthropic institutions in adopting these centers. Madam Speaker, we are all aware that lakhs of families in our country have to borrow or sell assets to receive indoor treatment in hospitals. Government is seriously concerned about the impoverishment of the poor and the vulnerable families. Presently, the Rashtriya Swasth Bima Yojana provides an annual coverage of only rupees 30,000 to poor families. Several state governments have also implemented and supplemented health protection schemes by providing varying coverages. My government has now decided to take healthcare protection to a new aspirational level. Madam, this is important. We are now launching a flagship national health protection scheme to cover 10 crore poor and vulnerable families. This is approximately 50 crore beneficiaries by providing them up to 5 lakh rupees per family per year for secondary and tertiary care hospitalization. This will be the world's largest government-funded healthcare program. Adequate funds will be provided for smooth implementation of this program. Madam Speaker, Madam, 10 करोड़ परिवार यानी 50 करोड़ लोगों को
5 लाख रुपए प्रति वर्ष हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन की सुविधा ये सरकार उपलब्ध करवाएगी। मैडम स्पीकर, दीज टू फार रीचिंग इनिशिएटिव्स अंडर आयुष्मान भारत प्रोग्राम विल बिल्ड अ न्यू इंडिया 2022 एंड इंश्योर एनहांस प्रोडक्टिविटी वेल बींग एंड अवर्ट वेज लॉस एंड इम्पॉवरिशमेंट। दीज स्कीम्स विल ऑल्सो जनरेट लैक्स ऑफ जॉब्स पर्टिकुलरली फॉर वुमेन। द गवर्नमेंट इज स्टेडली बट श्योरली प्रोग्रेसिंग टुवर्ड्स अ गोल ऑफ यूनिवर्सल हेल्थ कवरेज। यानी कि इस 50 करोड़ की जो सुविधा है उसको आगे भी एक्सपेंड किया जाएगा इस एक्सपेरिमेंट को देखने के बाद। ट्यूबरकुलोसिस क्लेम्स मोर लाइव्स एवरी ईयर देन एनी अदर इंफेक्शियस डिजीज। इट इफेक्ट्स मेनली पुअर एंड मैलनरिश्ड पीपल। माई गवर्नमेंट हैज देयरफॉर डिसाइडेड टू एलोकेट रुपीज 600 करोड़ टू प्रोवाइड न्यूट्रिशनल सपोर्ट टू ऑल टीबी पेशेंट्स एट द रेट ऑफ रुपीज 500 पर मंथ फॉर द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ देयर ट्रीटमेंट। इन ऑर्डर टू फर्दर एनहांस एक्सेसिबिलिटी ऑफ क्वालिटी मेडिकल एजुकेशन एंड हेल्थ केयर विल बी सेटिंग अप 24 न्यू गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल कॉलेजेस एंड हॉस्पिटल्स by upgrading existing district colleges in the country, district hospitals in the country. This would ensure at least one medical college for every 3 parliamentary constituencies and at least one government medical college in each state in the country. Our resolve of making our villages open defecation free is aimed at improving the quality of life of our villages. We will launch a scheme called for galvanizing organic bio agro resources dhan, gobar dhan, for management and conversion of cattle dung and solid waste in farm to compost, fertilizer, biogas and bio CNG. The Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Bima Yojana has benefited 5.22 crore families with life insurance cover of 2 lakhs on payment of premium of rupees 330 per annum. Likewise, under the Prime Minister's Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, 13 crore 25 lakh people have been insured with personal accident cover of rupees 2 lakhs on payment of a premium of only rupees 12 per annum. The government will work to cover all poor households, including scheduled caste, scheduled tribe households, under these in a mission mode. The government will expand the coverage under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana by bringing all the 60 crore bank accounts within its fold and undertake measures to provide services of micro insurance and unorganized sector pension schemes through these accounts. Our commitment towards Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao is unflinching. Sukanya Smriti account scheme launched in January 2015 has been a great success. Until November 2017, more than 1.26 crore accounts have been opened across the country in the name of the girl child, securing an amount of ₹19,183. Cleaning of Ganga is an important national importance, and it is our firm commitment that members will be happy to learn that the work is gathered speed. A total of 187 projects have been sanctioned under the Namami Gange program for infrastructure development and river surface cleaning, rural sanitation and other interventions at a cost of ₹16,713 crores. 47 projects have been completed and the remaining projects are at the various stages of execution. All 4,465 Ganga Gram villages